okay. Now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these eyes ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only when it gets exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only when it gets exception on my crew. Yeah. Ain't no dub, ain't no L. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the New York Giants. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. Jones on first and 10, and that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. A little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
Now Jones. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Off play action, Jones. It's complete to Golden Tate. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 16 yards, a first down.
First down, Giants.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Throwing on first down, Jones. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Javon Hargrave, the D tackle, getting the sack.
Second down.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Jones, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. Looking for Amendola, and it's intercepted. Cravon LeBlanc with a pick. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
At their own 36-yard line.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their 36-yard line. 54 Mike. They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. And finally, he is out of bounds, but not before taking it down near the 15. It's a big play there for the Eagles. 48 yards on the ground. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Now Sanders. And he'll be be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
He was brought down.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Hurt sets up to throw it. His throw caught at about the five. And the Eagles are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the four-yard line. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
The four-yard line.
They'll run with Sanders, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
So often you hear that pep talks don't really work in the heat of the battle, but collectively, this defense has to say to each other, we've been on our heels this whole first drive. This is where we need to dig in. And they got a nice stop right there for a loss on first and goal.
Back at the five-yard line now, second and goal. It'll be Hurts on the option. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Jalen Hurts with touchdown number eight on the year. And the Eagles have taken the early lead. We saw so much of this last year at the college level, but there you go. His first rushing touchdown as an NFL quarterback.
And with the speed he has, we certainly know it won't be his last, because that's something that aided him very well, as you mentioned, at the college level. It's something he's going to carry over, and they'll make it a big part of their offense.
And his kick is good, but flags come in. Looks like we're going to get a roughing call here in the 403. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Here's Dante Pettis on the return. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at about the 32. Off the play fake, he'll set up to throw it. They'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
Down, New York.
Jones now, throwing on first down. And that is intercepted by the Pro Bowl corner, Darius Slay. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Yikes, a four-yard loss really sets him back now for second down. As he's taken down at the 31.
Deion Buchanan.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
And a throw there going to be incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out and giving the ball back to their offense.
On is the punter, Johnston, now as he sends this one away. And this will be down just on the other side of midfield.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 46-yard line.
The Giants' offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers. And that, Jones has just thrown his third interception. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
This play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. Big Leonard Williams, the one who came in and got him.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. They go play action with Hurts. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
Hurts. This will be taken in by Hightower. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
They have a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first.
No good.
So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, set this one off target.
Now Saquon Barkley, a man who played collegiately here in the Keystone State. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Nothing.
The gun, Jones. He's got the first down and more past midfield. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two.
First down.
Week 7 action, and we've got a 7-point game here in the second quarter. And this offense hoping to change that right here. That is caught inside the 5. So they hit pay dirt, but don't count it yet. There's laundry on the field. We'll see what the penalty flag is about. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Operating from the gun. Jones. It's caught outright. Amendola. Jones. That catch good for only a couple.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Second down, here's Barkley. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
Now Jones throwing on third and long. Over the middle, it's Amendola. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. They get 15, but they still needed a little bit more. Fourth down. Here's Jones throwing on fourth down. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Evan Engram, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. That took a pretty big risk right there, going for it on fourth down. But, hey, not only did they get the first down, forget about that, they got in the end zone.
Yeah, because normally you're just thinking, can I get enough yardage to get it past the sticks and pick up a first down? Instead, they go for the end zone and get it done with no margin for error. Remember, fourth down, they went for it.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they've got to be a little bit frustrated about that last drive, missed field goal.
Always hurts a team because, you know, you put something out there, you've given yourself a chance, you're in range, and the ball doesn't go through the post. But it's not something to panic about, I don't believe. Just keep playing and keep going. They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. From the gun, it's Hurts. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That one was all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And this is caught by Watkins. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down. Boston Scott, his first carry. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Second and 14. Here's Hurts to throw. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 36. It's a gain of 22 as we tick towards the two-minute warning.
36-yard line.
So the drive takes them into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 36. They'll run with Sanders. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the two-minute warning.
Gain on the play, second and 10, at the 36-yard line.
Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Oh, what a juke into space! And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
3rd and 3.
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. For the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left hash, this from 46. And this one is right down Broadway. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. So he gets a shot at atoning for the earlier miss here in the first half and able to knock it through.
You think? Because how many games have we done where kickers missed one early and never got a chance to atone for it the rest of the game? That's a lot to carry around.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff.
He's got a man complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 36 yards on the play.
Giants.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he's taken down inside the 30. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Jones on first down, escaping the pressure right. And this one's incomplete. The intended target, Saquon Barkley, but it's going to be second down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
They'll set up the screen to Barkley. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space, the big guys leading the way.
They'll try and run for it with Barkley. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. From back at the 4, here's second and goal. Off the play fake, Jones. And Ingram's got it. Touchdown, Giants.
Complete to Evan Ingram.
Evan Ingram. As the first half is winding down. And the Giants are going to jump back in front. CD for them. This has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17.
At their own 17-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
First and 10 at the 34-yard line.
from the 34 now. Here's first and 10. Throwing is Hurts. Eluding the pressure right. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now.
Incomplete on the throwaway. Brings up second and 10.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. This is complete to Watkins on the slam. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
They'll throw now on the final play. Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. So we come upon halftime here with the visiting Giants out on top as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Graham Gano set to kick off.
It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell me before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Side on the swing pass, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
Barkley will try to punch it in. And he is in. Touchdown, Giants.
Touchdown.
Saquon Barkley. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Giants use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. It's good, and it's 21-10.
Makes the score Giants 21, Eagles 10.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily that you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't. A big seam, and he might go all the way. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Dallas got her. His second touchdown on the season. There the Eagles are back within a score. Coaches must really like to see that from the quarterback because he's had the interceptions in this game, but they're able to connect on the touchdown pass.
And teammates love to see that because they know that they miss blocks during a game, but they come back and make them later on. They miss tackles, right? They miss making plays, but the spotlight is magnified on your quarterback. And when he stands up to the front,
and it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Eagles 16. Jake Elliott.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
On the pickup, it's second and 8.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Now this time he'll look to throw. And he'll get this underneath, dropping it off for Barkley. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
New York.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. They'll run with Barkley. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
That was a beautifully executed screen pass. Let the rushers get upfield. The blocking forms in front. Lofted it to the runner. And now, not only does he have open space in front of him, he's got an escort as well. And they pick up big yardage.
Throwing Jones. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown.
Evan Ingram.
His third touchdown of the game, his 8th on the year. And the Giants add on to their lead. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
At their own 18-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. A quick throw into the hands of Rager. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Check.
second down. Here's Hurts. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
Now a carry for Sanders. Now this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Another run here with Sanders. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
But first down, Hurts. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. This is caught inside the 15. And this will get him all the way inside the Giants' 10. A big play there for Philly. 49 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. John Hightower, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score. Elliott on for the extra point. This is back to a five-point game.
Makes the score, Giants 28, Eagles.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They've been rolling the last couple of drives, each ending in touchdowns. So this game is flipped. They were down, now they're up with the football. We'll see how they handle it.
Can we get a spy on the headset now between the head coach and offensive coordinator? Because they've been in attack mode, had to get back into the game. Now they have the lead. Do you stay on the attack, or do you dial it back a little bit to try and protect this lead?
Well, my cop-out answer would be somewhere in the middle. I think it's going to be a fine line, is it not?
I think you're exactly right, but I do think if they can stay aggressive and keep them on their heels, they'll be best served that way.
Barkley, a first down and more. Busting free at the 10. And finally out of bounds inside the 5 at the 4. A tremendous play there from Saquon Barkley. 58 yards. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. On the run, it's Barkley. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
I know the game's not over, but there's got to be a sense of satisfaction right now for the guy carrying the football a bunch today. 99 yards, and he has enough time to go over the century mark.
Well, you got to give it to him again, right?
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. You're not worried about losing yardage here. You're not worried about any of that. You just want to get him to the promised land for every runner, 100 yards or more in a game.
That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
And now third and goal coming up, the loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
Dancing to his left. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Kalavon Chason in there to record the second sack of his young NFL career.
Graham Gano on for the field goal.
And the 11-year veteran bangs it through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. Eagles. From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And remember, despite giving up the field goal, this is still a one-score game. They're in need of the touchdown and a two-point conversion. A field goal on this drive likely doesn't do them much good. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Being chased out left. And this will be incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hoping to get that to John Hightower. And that takes us from second to third down.
Third down and 10.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And this is caught. That's Watkins. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That third down conversion good for 23.
At the 38-yard line.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 38. Hurts sets up to throw it. Trying to lay one up deep. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he'll go down at the 28. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
The Eagles on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. John Hightower, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Eagles move back within a couple of the lead.
So they got the touchdown they needed to cut this to 2, but now they've got to get back to the huddle. No celebration time. Got to figure out what they're going to do on the two-point conversion.
Hurts. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan.
It's interesting that when it comes to two-point conversions, even heavy run teams tend to throw the ball in these situations. In this case, this one was intercepted.
Yeah, they weren't fooled. They were ready for the pass, picked it off. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. A break there for this offense as they will get a chance to start at the 40-yard line.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on first and 10. Flush to his right. It's caught on the right side at Smith. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock. And this is second and less than a yard. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's no gain on the play, and they'll remain a few inches shy of a first with third down looming. So here we go, Charles, third down. Any chance you're throwing?
I don't think so. I think you got to keep the clock rolling here.
And indeed, they will keep it on the ground. And Barkley did not get there. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as it'll come with an even 90 seconds remaining on the clock. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
49, guys. Mike, 49. Switch up. 49 on the mic. Watch 49. I'm here.
From the gun, Jones. And that is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. To throw. He'll hit Watkins on the crossing route. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
They'll look to throw. This short throw caught by Goddard. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Inside of a minute to go now, 2 timeouts left, still in pretty good shape.
I think they're in excellent shape here if they use the timeouts judiciously and use the sideline as an additional timeout.
Wide open is Watkins, he's got him. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation. But to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but that you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get over-eager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Catch made at the 25-yard line. The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Mills. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
At their own 31-yard line.
They start on the ground here in Sanders. And he'll be tackled at about the 35.
26 miles.
The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game.
Second and 6.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Hurts going to keep this himself. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And it'll be 3rd and 10 now. They'll set up a throw. This will be taken in by Hightower. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
7-yard line. Tonight's final score is
a great come from behind victory in this one, Charles. And really the difference, obviously, was that fourth quarter. They dominated.
And it has to start with believing that you can make that comeback. Because we've been in games before. We've done games where you just look at one team and realize they have no chance of making it back. Not in the one we just saw here. They did it, and they did it well.
So for the Eagles,
we just ran in the spot, and they would spin the block around just like the hell on the clock.